Today I'm speaking to Alan Plowman, who's the Deputy Head of CFDs and Listed Products in Saxo Bank, and we'll be looking at price formation in the crude market. Alan, we've seen crude trading sideways for the past couple of weeks. Is there an indication there that the way that the price is created within the market is changing slightly?
Well, there have been a number of events over the past couple of weeks that might indicate that. So first event, if we look more so from a fundamental perspective, we had the EIA come out and say that they were acknowledging certain other factors as drivers in the market. Much of the story that we were talking about, say, a year and a half ago, with crude oil being used as an investment vehicle, and therefore is now more subject to other influences such as the dollar, the price of dollar, stock market correlations alongside with that as well. So even though it's old news, I think it's also important to recognize that the industry that is behind the physical side of crude, that would be the fundamental side of crude as well, is like acknowledging that there are many other factors right now driving the market than just physical demand and supply.
And what sort of factors are those that are having more of an effect?
Well, I mean, the stock market being the obvious. Now, I think we've enough times talked about, heavy dependencies on correlations between the stock market and the price of crude, which has been high. Likewise, inverse correlations between the dollar, et cetera, and crude as well. All of these indicate that people are relying very heavily on strong correlations. Now, there's a danger in this, and the danger is that, and in line with our outrageous claims for this year, we anticipated that the VIX index, that would be the volatility index, would be dropping dramatically. We have a target of 14 on that index, which is historical lows. And so, and at the same time, if we go back to when volatilities were at historical highs, typically markets are highly correlated. But even though volatility is at historical lows, we're still seeing that markets are highly correlated. And this is something of a concern for us, because we believe at some point in time we're going to have to rely more on physical demand and supply to be able to tell us which way the price will be moving forward.
Okay. I mean, in terms of physical demand and supply, what's the situation at the moment?
Well, so demand growth is there as there are many of the economic data that's coming out is pointing to an increase in consumption. Okay, but it's there, but we're not there yet, if you want to put it like that, just to indicate that we are seeing positive signs, but we're not where we used to be when prices were at current levels in crude oil. Supplies are healthy right now. And although we're coming into the driving season right now, in the US, for example, we still haven't seen any great depletions of supply. In other words, we're well above cyclical averages and what we anticipate we should be right now. Now, there's a bit of a disparity between what I think is one of the key indicators right now between physical and supply, demand and supply, and that is, when you look at what's being traded on the physical side, currently freight rates, and that would be tank freight rates, are hovering above what are very, very low rates. And that's simply because there's no demand out there. Now, there is an excess supply in the freight market, and there will be more excess supply in the freight market coming forward. But right now, the high prices in crude and what is perceived demand and against what will be a tightening supply situation, which is all a matter of perception, hasn't converted into the freight market. And that says that the underlying trade on the physical side is not necessarily supporting the high prices in crude. And this is why I believe that we could see a correction moving into the next week or 2 weeks.
Okay. Is that a problem that there isn't the physical trade there to support it?
The problem is that... But it's not a problem in as such. It's just a matter of finding what you think is a good price in the market. So the price of crude has increased very much in line with expectations, but hasn't necessarily been underpinned by what we see as the physical demand we also need to see in trade and trade going through the market to be able to underpin these prices. Mm-hmm. And so just a disparity between what is perceived future demand as opposed to what we're seeing right now. All of this, of course, is built on perceived future growth.
Yeah.
Now, there's an interesting dynamic that also happened throughout the week that traders will like to know as well. And that was in line with the Goldman story, we saw some small increases in volatility. And we talked briefly about the volatility index before. The brief increases in volatility led to a sell-off in commodities in general. Now, just sort of anecdotally, we really have to see this as sort of a risk aversion play. Now, we saw it especially in gold, and where we saw a liquidating market as we saw equities get liquidated on the back of fears surrounding Goldman's fraud case. Mm-hmm. So it was a knee-jerk reaction in the market, and we saw a jump back, so a recovery based on the fact that it's being isolated to Goldman's. But the reality is increased in volatility led to risk aversion, led to commodities being sold off. And that was an interesting dynamic to see on the basis that you know, we need to always, even though we don't want to rely on heavy correlations to the stock market, we always need to look that way to give us an indication of which way the short-term dynamic in the market is going to take us.
Mm-hmm. And just to finish on technical levels, what are you looking at for crude at the moment?
Okay, so when we saw the sold-off, we saw when we saw the sell-off, we saw 80-70 hit in West Texas. That was a technical level. We indicated also as a level to watch from our weekly commodity update. We still believe that's a technical level to watch. Now we could drop even further down to 75 levels, and although in percentage-wise it's a big move, it would still keep the long-term bull trend, to which you know, we believe will be sustainable, even though we drop back down to $75. So a correction could be, what is it, healthy in the market for the long-term bull trend, but right now, you know, we're still seeing concerns regarding whether we'll be able to make it through the existing highs anyway.
Okay. Alan, thanks a lot for that.
Pleasure. Thank you.